Welcome to Shooting Blanks Entertainment Presents, the Commentators Podcast. I'm Kramer.
I'm Juan.
I'm Tom.
And today we are going over the Captain America. America.
You're going to say Captain Mario, weren't you?
No, I was about to say Captain America.
Captain America Civil War trailer.
I've been saying America so much that I can't even say America anymore.
Oh, we're going to talk about the Captain America Civil War trailer.
Captain America trailer?
You know, we're going through a civil war nowadays anyway. We need
it's a civil war. You know, it's again.
Obama.
This is a civil war of superheroes, so we're not talking about America right now. We're talking about Captain America. Civil War America.
I need to see that damn birth certificate. Are there about to be a civil war up in here? Yeah. Okay. So what was it, Kramer?
The Captain America Civil War trailer.
Yeah.
Where we finally get a glimpse of Black Panther.
This is true. First off, it's really awesome. The whole trailer.
Yeah.
Super emotional. I felt sad. I felt so sad.
Yeah. It was way more of a, because I thought it was going to be, at least the trailer itself was going to be very focused on the Accord. What is it called?
The Sokovia Accords.
Yeah.
Which they showed. Like on paper, that little booklet they're passing to Captain America, which is awesome because that answered the question that you also answered when we saw Ant-Man, and they showed that scene that they show in the beginning where Bucky's stuck in the thing.
Yeah.
And he's like, Captain America, was it Captain America? He's like, the Accords, I don't think the Accords would let us do something. And then you were like, I was like, what's an Accord? And you were like, oh, it's a law or something.
It's something like a law or like international law.
Yeah.
I think.
Well, it seems like that's what it is.
Yeah, because you hear like peace accords and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And it's normally between like different countries and stuff like that. I'm not sure, which might explain, especially if it's an international thing, why Black Panther might be thrown into the mix.
I believe an accord is actually an agreement.
An agreement. That makes more sense.
Yes.
Oh, that makes sense. Yeah. Now that I use it in a sentence.
But it's still like, it's still international, right?
A lot.
It's more of an international thing.
No, I think it's just a word for an agreement because I've heard a lot in pirate movies.
And
we have an accord.
I like how we're doing it out of context from like CNN. And Tom gets it out of context from like Pirates of the Caribbean.
Hey, I still feel like my context is more relevant.
No, he's right. He's right. Yeah. It's definitely an agreement.
All right.
But it does look like there's a UN kind of thing going on in the trailer.
Yeah, that explosion definitely looks like a UN. It has all those weird seated things. Maybe, I don't know, somebody blows it up.
But where is Black Panther from?
Wakanda.
Wakanda?
Yeah.
Is that actually a country in Africa?
No. And the prize for the person who knows nothing. No, it's not a real place.
But he's...
Don't quote.
He is like one of the most richest guys. He is the richest guy in the Marvel Universe?
He's the president of Wakanda.
I've heard or seen charts where like they have everybody's different wealth from like the superhero world. And it goes, I think it's like Iron Man or Tony Stark. Not Iron Man or Batman. I don't remember which one is above. I know Arrow... Green Arrow's below them.
Spider-Man's way at the bottom.
Spider-Man
is the poorest.
He has like 5 cents. He has the bus fare. That's all he has.
He sells pictures of himself for a living.
Yeah. He sells selfies.
He sells selfies. Oh my God. Living.
That's what Spider-Man does.
Whoa. I never thought about that. Damn.
Yeah. Fuck. He's not making money.
Unless he's got an Instagram sponsorship or something like that.
Well, right. I've never actually seen it where it's... Like digital, he's always using analog cameras.
What?
There's gonna be a picture of him with like. Have you seen those Instagram ads for like Fit Tea?
It just has Spider-Man in his Spider-Man costume, but he's wearing a T-shirt on top of it.
Yeah. He's holding a little bottle, a can of that Fit Tea bag stuff. Help you lose weight in 30 days.
Oh, it's a tea.
Yeah, it's a tea.
You meant like
no,
t-shirts.
Not a T-shirt.
You would go straight to that.
I call T-shirts T-shirts.
I heard him called tees a lot. Like T Fury or Turtle T, those don't websites that sell T shirts. I hate you, Tom.
Did you just call me Tom?
I did just call you Tom.
Oh man. That means you hate me even more.
It's a deep-seated hatred that came out. Why do you think they're gonna incorporate that into like Spider-Man movies now?
How poor he is?
No, not just how poor he is.
I'm pretty sure they do that already.
He does essentially sell selfies. She sells selfies by the seashore. I can't say that properly. But like, he does sell selfies. But now that it's in modern times, do you think the upgraded Spider-Man movies are going to start putting it to where he's on, like, he has an Instagram account?
Or I hope not.
That well, no, because you can't sell an Instagram account.
Yeah.
Well, there's people that get, like, money off of Instagram.
Yeah, but not people that take pictures of Spider-Man. That's true. That's more like people who have boobs.
That's true. Unless he has, like, a Spider-Man selfie. Like, page, like, where he has Spider-Man on the account.
If he has a selfie account, he'll never make money, like, to the paper, because they're not going to want to buy it.
That's true.
Not to mention, people would, you know, trace his IP address and find out who the fuck is Spider-Man.
Yeah.
The government's just going to be like, oh, this guy is
posting. No, he would totally just do it out of the library. Spider-Man doesn't have a computer.
Spider-Man totally has a computer.
He doesn't have a laptop.
He has a dark room.
How does he Photoshop all this stuff, then?
Dark room.
Dark room, yeah. He doesn't Photoshop.
No Photoshop.
Film.
Then how does he put it on the internet?
He doesn't.
You just talked about a blog.
Because he's going to switch to cell phones. He's just going to have, like, does Spider-Man have a selfie stick?
What?
He would have to. No,
he uses his webs.
And then he has a remote for his camera.
Yeah. I can imagine, like, he throws his phone up, and he uses the web, and it misses, and his phone just, like, falls and breaks. And he's like, oh, fuck, I can't afford to get another phone.
That's why he uses...
There goes my modeling career.
That's why he uses film cameras. Can't afford digital ones. Just breaks them all.
They're just like Polaroids that he gets with the camera. Yeah. Like Walmart. Or not Walmart. Walgreens.
Disposable cameras.
Yeah.
So if he drops it, oh well.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, back to the trailer.
Back to the... Like, okay, so...
Wait. Let's start at the beginning of the trailer because we're jumping everywhere.
Okay.
What happened at the beginning of the trailer?
It was Captain America talking to Bucky.
Oh, yeah. He's stuck in that thing. How did he get his arm stuck in that machine?
I don't know what's going
on. It's weird.
We'll find out.
But yeah.
Captain America is not in uniform.
Yeah.
He's just, like, there as himself.
So is Falcon.
Oh, that's true. Were they just, like, going for a jog? And they're like, hey, look, there's a building. Let's go to the building.
If they showed a clip where Falcon and Captain America are standing there and the government is, like, taking their stuff.
Mm.
Or some guys in suits are taking the shield and they have Falcon's suit. So maybe this is after that. Maybe they get their stuff taken away and they're looking.
They somehow find Bucky?
Oh, I can see how they would they'd be confiscating their stuff because it looks like he was on trial. As in, like, they were like, hey, you know, you've been doing this stuff as pretty much a criminal at this point as we see it because we never authorized you to keep doing what you're doing. You're just doing it on your own will.
Mm.
Yeah.
So, you know, at this point, we're not, you know.
Vigilantism.
Yeah.
Okay.
They call them a vigilante. They're like, we're not tolerating this anymore.
So I thought they all that came after, like, after the thing with Bucky, because they're like, they're going after Bucky, and then Captain America would interfere with that, and they're like, what the fuck? You're supposed to be a good guy, and now we're seeing that you just do whatever the fuck you want, and that's when they take the stuff.
No, yeah, it's totally possible that in the act of him trying to save Bucky, they caught both of them.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. That's what I figured happened, but that would mean like that their stuff was confiscated afterwards.
Well, yeah, it was probably after that.
Yeah.
I was thinking maybe they confiscated it first. Like, they get the news that, look, all your stuff has repercussions now.
Mm-hmm.
So he decides he's not going to go with whatever they're doing. So they're like, well, we're taking your stuff. It was all government stuff.
But see, where that goes wrong is that would mean that they're like, okay, just because you've been a vigilante before, we're just going to start taking your stuff. But that means they would have taken Iron Man's suits as well.
No, I'm assuming that they're telling him, you can work with us type thing and continue it, but you'll work for the government. And he doesn't want to do that. And Iron Man does agree to that because he's finally feeling the guilt of everything he's done. So he's like, yeah, I should help the government. I should be held accountable. And Captain America's like, no. So they're like, well, you can't have this stuff. Like, we gave it to you. So they're taking it back. And then I assume at some point he's going to have to steal
Captain America
back.
Got repoed?
Yeah.
Well, my thoughts are...
He doesn't own anything.
go ahead, Tom.
Well, my thoughts are is that, you know, they're probably working on the same side as far as, like, Captain America and Tony Stark. Mm-hmm. They're working on the same side with the government. But then whenever, they find out the target is Bucky...
That's where he starts to get a little rogue.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah, and that's when he's all like, no, this is my friend. He's not doing what you're saying he's doing.
And yeah, that's when they make him turn over his stuff. Like, if you're not with us, then
exactly.
You can't be with us.
Although,
but he does have it with Bucky at some point, so I assume he steals it back. Probably. And Falcon's gear.
That makes sense.
That's probably where Ant-Man comes in. sneaking into places because Ant-Man is supposed to be in this movie.
Oh, yeah, they didn't show him at all, huh?
They didn't show him at all, but even...
Or he wasn't there, but just really tiny.
I saw something about that, yeah.
Like, what if he was just in the background little? Or on someone's shoulder?
You frame it, like, you like pause it, and you zoom in on the frame, and just on Captain America's shoulder, there's a little bump. And that's just Ant-Man.
I like that, yeah.
Because zoom in enough, it's Paul Rudd's face.
Because the rest of that scene that they showed in Ant-Man was Falcon's like, I know a guy, which they're referring to Ant-Man. So I assume at that point, yeah, Bucky's the target. He's deciding he's going to help his friend because he knows Bucky's not under mind control anymore. And then that's where shit starts really getting separated.
Yeah. I was going to bring up something because we were talking about how Captain America gets his stuff repossessed because it's not technically his. The government gave it to him. And then we were talking about he doesn't technically own anything.
Yeah, I don't think he owns anything. He doesn't have any money.
Yeah, they show a lot of scenes where he's just in regular people clothes. And I started thinking, where does he go home? Does he have like government subsidy housing or like does he have an apartment that's given to him?
He has an apartment in Winter Soldier. You haven't seen, so I'm not going to ruin stuff.
Yeah, that was like the only Marvel one I haven't seen because I was like, it's a Captain America movie. How much storyline can there be in it?
Apparently tons.
All of the storyline.
It's a lot.
As soon as I saw Age of Ultron, when it started, I was like, what? What's going on?
But yeah, he has an apartment. I think S.H.I.E.L.D. gives it to him. And that's where he lives.
Okay.
And
I think he gets a paycheck, right? Like as a soldier, he gets a paycheck.
Probably.
Maybe they still pay him the 50s paycheck. Oh. He doesn't know any better. They're like, here's $5, Captain America. Good job. Like,
I'm going to go get into movies.
Yes. I'm going to go watch a movie and buy like a bunch of stuff.
I'm going to take my gal out for what is it? A float. I'm going to take my gal out for a float.
A hot dog.
Where are the float shops?
Floating a hot dog.
I can only get a hot dog for this $5?
What do you mean this drink isn't a penny?
I can't put chili on my hot dog unless I have $2 more. What is this? This used to cost 10 cents.
Oh, that's another thing. Like, because remember we were talking about Captain America's powers last time, about how he's technically just a human in the ultimate fit shape. It's not like nuclear radiation. It's just like if a human was at their peak performance, that would be Captain America.
Yes.
Yes.
And I was reading an article about like J.J. Watt and his exercises and like how he now jumps this high or works out this much to get this much.
Yeah.
He eats 10,000 calories a day.
That's a lot.
How much does Captain America eat? Because he's not doing that on a $5 every 2 weeks paycheck.
I don't know. Maybe he gets free food. Maybe everything he gets is free because he's Captain America.
That's true.
I mean, he probably doesn't have to pay for anything.
They are kind of like, you know what? We kind of did make you a government experiment. So, oh, yeah, he gets like probably like a VA check.
But you know what I was thinking? Like, even a person from the trailer, if he's supposed to be just like a super fit person, like the toppest of what you can be, can a super, super fit person that we know of like now hold a helicopter on the side of a building as he's holding like the building and keep it from flying away?
How much does a helicopter weigh?
I assume a couple, a ton.
That's not necessarily the issue. The issue is being able to fight the propulsion.
Yeah, because it's pulling away. And
just makes it harder.
He looks like he's struggling a little, but he's holding it.
You're
not
holding it up. You're holding it down.
Yeah.
That seems way more than just your average. Even if you were at top physical condition.
Because physically speaking, if a helicopter is going up, then it's lifting the amount of weight that it weighs plus some to go upwards. So holding it down require even more strength.
And he's holding the side of the building and holding the helicopter, and it's not going anywhere. And he looks even like he's pulling it in.
I think
And he's running as fast as a car, but I guess maybe some people can get close. Like Usain Bolt.
Yeah.
Not a super speeding car, but at least a moderately going car.
And I don't think there is a human like that because I think in powerlifting, one thing that's considered a myth of powerlifting or like the goal that everybody's trying to reach is the 3K, which is 1,000 pounds bench, 1,000 pounds squat, and 1,000 pounds deadlift. And nobody has reached that yet. So for somebody, or like a 3,000 pounds combined. Between all three of those lifts. Because there's people who can like deadlift over like 1,000 pounds or squat over 1,000 pounds.
But can't do all three?
For the bench?
Is that what you mean? Like they want to be able to, one person wants to be able to do all three of those
like the
things?
The weights should all add up to 3,000 pounds.
Okay, yeah.
But nobody has reached that yet. And so for somebody like a helicopter itself, that's at least 3,000 pounds of like weight.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I'm going to say no.
He's got to be way more.
He's enhanced. Like past the human limits.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, but you got to understand it's also in the superhero universe. So that's true. He's got to be exaggerated a
There's also
bit.
A guy who can shrink down to the size of a net.
This is true. But yeah.
With the help of a suit.
With the help of a suit. Yeah.
But still.
Well, can. Not the help, the entire.
The entire suit.
That's the reason.
Yeah. None of the shrinking is him.
Yeah. Yeah. But.
Ah, well, anyway. I guess, just going back to the trailer. They get that beginning. They're shown the Accords. Bucky's escaping the police.
Yeah.
They're all coming for him.
So they must find out through them, like, that Bucky's there.
Yeah.
Because I don't understand, or at least we might find out in the movie, like, how they found out where Bucky was exactly at the same time as the police. Maybe they got the same tip and they just got there first.
Maybe they found out the tip and they're going to see. And Bucky just running, like, off that building, jumping off, looks so cool.
And speaking of, like, the chasing, or maybe, am I jumping ahead?
I think you're jumping a little.
Okay.
Okay, well, one thing, too, is the return of General Thunderbolt Ross, from The Incredible Hulk. He's the guy that comes out with the mustache, and he's like, y'all guys have been doing whatever you want, you know.
Is that him?
That's him.
Huh.
So he is from The Hulk. He's coming back. That's really cool.
Still the only Hulk movie in the series.
Yeah, yeah.
But still. Unless we get Hulk in space.
Speaking of, he's supposed to be in Thor Ragnarok.
Ooh.
The Hulk's supposed to be in there. Originally, he was going to be in Civil War at some point. Like, they had a scene of him. Mm-hmm. And then for whatever reason, they decided, we're not going to do that.
Yeah.
So like Mark Ruffalo said, like, oh, yeah, I was supposed to be in Civil War, and they cut it. But now they pretty much confirmed that he's going to be in Thor. Apparently he is in space now. Yeah. And it's going to be super cool.
In Ultron, he flew out into space, right?
They just show him flying. I don't think they showed him going into space.
But it's kind of implied?
Maybe. Like, that's the thing. It was so open-ended that it could have been anything.
I want Planet Hulk. I need Planet Hulk.
Maybe after he helps Thor, the Asgardians banish him to another planet or something. Mm. And that's where he finds the planet.
That would. Maybe. I've been waiting for that because Planet Hulk is like my favorite Hulk.
Yeah, that'd be pretty cool. It'd be mostly like CGI, though.
Yeah, because he wouldn't actually be able to be human.
Mm-mm. No, I think in Planet Hulk, he's Hulk all the time.
Yeah. So.
But the Hulk itself becomes like more sentient. Well, I mean, it's sentient, but like it's more self-aware.
Yeah.
And it's more controlled. Because he becomes like the leader on that planet, right?
Yeah.
After like the whole gladiators like kind of thing.
Gladiator like king afterwards.
Mm. Yes.
And then they come back to take over Earth.
Yes.
Yeah, they were starting to show a little bit how he could control the Hulk in Age of Ultron.
Mm-hmm. That's true. They were getting to that point.
So that's pretty exciting.
Maybe. Yeah.
Okay, then another tie to Ultron, Age of Ultron, was, of course, the Black Panther.
Yeah, because they hinted at Black Panther and Age of Ultron with them being in Wakanda.
They were in Wakanda. They had vibranium and...
Because that's one of the things that makes him rich is that he has a bunch of vibranium mines.
He has the only like vibranium mines. Mm. They're only in Wakanda and they're under his control.
Okay.
Yeah. So that's pretty cool. And then when they shoot that like pan up and you can see his like full body face.
Yeah.
It looks pretty awesome. Also the fact that he's freaking running faster than Captain America.
Mm-hmm.
Who that shouldn't happen.
Yes.
That should not be happening.
I'm so excited.
And Captain America is like running faster than a car, jumps on top of the car to get past it. And he's just, Black Panther's just going super fast.
I know.
Super cool.
But he's chasing Bucky, right?
Where?
In that
Yeah, no, he's chasing Black Panther?
No, Captain America is chasing Black Panther, but Black Panther's chasing Bucky.
They didn't show him chasing Bucky. They just show him running.
Okay.
Which means...
I guess it was the way it was cut, I assumed he was chasing.
He could have been chasing Bucky. I don't think Bucky can run that fast.
No.
I think they also showed Bucky... getting kicked by Black Panther in the chest. So maybe he kind of interferes somewhere, and now he's trying to get away.
I want to say Black Panther is going to end up being on Iron Man's side, because from what I saw in the trailer, everybody was against Iron Man.
I think he's going to be neutral for now. That's just an opinion.
I don't know. A kick to the chest doesn't seem pretty neutral.
Well, if you attack him, he's going to fight back.
Yeah.
And maybe that's something that happens. Maybe he's just trying to do his own thing. He gets caught up in a little bit of this, and he's just like, fuck everybody.
So you think he might have... I don't want to say he's going to have a minor role. Because there was a lot of him in the trailer.
He could, but I hope not. Yeah. There's so much going on. Like, you'd have to limit his role at least a little bit. He's supposed to get his own movie, I think.
Yeah, I was
going to
say, was that
so next this year? Just is an introduction.
Is that movie next year? Or
I don't remember. It might be. Or the year after that. Something like that. And then Spider-Man is supposed to be in this movie, too.
Oh, yeah, but then it show him much, huh?
No, they're not going to. I don't think they'll show him.
Yeah. They might just show him, like, not in the suit, just, like, as a teenager.
No, I don't think the... If anything, I think they'll do it like they did the Vision in Ultron. So the Vision was such a, like, big character mm-hmm. that the only thing you ever saw of him in the trailer was his eyes open. And, like, it was way at the end of, like, the second to last trailer, I think. His eyes pop open and his... You can see, like, the weird thing in his eyes moving around. Mm. And that's the end of the trailer. That's all you see of the Vision, which was perfect because we didn't get a full reveal to the movie.
Yeah.
If they do that, maybe, like, closer to May, we'll get something of, like, one brief shot of him.
But in the movie itself, there should be some.
Maybe just yeah. Spider-Man. Yeah. Or something.
It's going to be a minor scene, though, because...
That's what I was asking. Is it going to be him in the suit? Or maybe in the movie, it's just, you know,
Peter Parker. They recast him as, yes. like, a kid or something.
Yeah, he's
a kid.
He's younger. He's supposed to be, like, for real, like, 16.
Like, maybe it's before he actually becomes Spider-Man? It's just still Peter Parker as a kid in the movie?
Maybe.
So no costume, maybe just him.
I think they shot his scenes in, like, a week. So it's something little. Oh,
he can't have too much then.
It's something little. He may have a costume, and he may just kind of show up very briefly to maybe help or something. Mm. Kind of, I'm thinking maybe in the sense of, like, did y'all see X-Men Days of Future Past?
Yeah.
How Quicksilver played a cool role, but he was really only in it for that one part to get Magneto out. And then they were like, okay, see you later. Maybe they kind of come across him. He helps a little bit, but decides he doesn't want to get involved. And they're like, okay, he's too young. They leave him.
I hope not. I hope they do something more because then it gives more for the Spider-Man movies.
Yeah, well, they're going to do a Spider-Man movie with that kid.
Okay.
Thing is though, in the continuity of Spider-Man, though, wasn't Spider-Man, like, a college kid whenever he became Spider-Man? He wasn't in high school, which a 16-year-old would be in high school.
I always remember him from being in high school.
Was he in high school?
Yeah.
I think there's different versions of it.
I thought he was, like...
I think he's always started out in high school.
Yeah?
Yeah, because that's where he gets his powers. He's just supposed to be a kid. Okay. And then he goes to college, like, later...
Yeah, because even though like it's they're on like a field trip or something where they go to the lab.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I was thinking it was like a college sort of thing. Okay, it might have been high school.
Yeah, I think the Tobey Maguire?
Yeah, the Tobey Maguire Spider-Man. He's in high school, but he's already like a senior at that point because they graduate and they're already talking about college. Like,
okay, no, I thought he was a college student in the Tobey Maguire one.
Oh, that's why it was so brief.
Yeah, but like, he's barely in high school. But then the other ones that they did, the ones that they canceled. Mm-hmm. That one, he was in high school.
Which ones?
The skateboarding Spider-Man.
Oh, yeah, he was in high school. He was too hip.
Like, how are you not cool?
I didn't like, exactly. That's what the thing, he's supposed to be kind of dorky. And Tobey Maguire was dorky.
Yeah.
But I just didn't like him. But the new one was too cool. I think that's something I can never get over. His hair was too perfect.
It was perfect.
His perfect hair.
He was perfect, and he's skateboarding, and I was like, you're a cool dude. Like, you can't... I guess. I thought the movies were okay, but...
Yeah.
I could never get, like, past that from the first one.
That makes sense, though.
Mm-hmm. I couldn't do the first ones because Kirsten Dunst. Like, Tobey Maguire was bad, but she is, like, the worst actress on the planet.
She wasn't bad in the first one.
The redhead?
Fucking terrible, yes.
Yeah. Oh, she was God. Mary Jane.
She ruined the whole movie. She was so fucking bad.
I don't remember too much of those movies because I remember I watched 1 and 2 when I was young, and then 3 I've never finished. I think I've started watching it like 3 different times, and each time I just stop. I'm like, I don't want to watch this.
They're not that good.
It makes me mad that I hate them because I know the dude they used for Jonah Jameson.
He's
amazing.
He was so good.
He was perfect.
He was so good.
William Dafoe was also perfect. Mm.
William Dafoe was super badass. He had that like creepy goblin face.
Yes.
He was so good. He didn't even need to wear the mask. The mask was not needed. He could have just been green.
Yeah. They straight up made him like that gold paint that they did in the comics with the purple hood. He would have been perfect. But even with the mask and everything, he was still great. Like those two characters were amazing. The rest of the movie was garbage.
Mm. Yeah.
And it made me so mad because they did such an amazing job and they'll never be recognized for it because of how shitty those movies were.
Yeah. I think that's what we were talking about, trying to remember. I was throwing out the idea of a podcast where we talked about the value of different actors.
Oh, yeah.
In terms of how much they get paid. And Chris Evans was one that we were talking about where, like, Captain America was his saving grace, mm-hmm. because of Fantastic Four, there was nothing.
Dude, even if Fantastic Four was terrible.
Yeah.
So bad.
All the stuff that he did in Fantastic Four was like, he might as well not even have had a resume.
Yeah.
But then, like, as soon as Captain America came out, like, we were talking about, like, how does Iron Man or Robert Downey Jr. get paid so much more than Chris Evans? And it's because, like, when Robert Downey Jr. came into it, like, even though he was coming off of all, like, those drug problems, he still had a huge resume of, like, movies.
Mm-hmm. Before that, yeah.
And people were waiting for him to come back. Whereas Chris Evans, they're like, you just came out of Fantastic Four. Technically, that's negative points.
Yeah.
He was lucky.
You gotta redeem yourself now.
He was lucky enough to do a superhero movie and then still get the part for another superhero movie.
Yeah. Think about it like that.
Well, you know what? I rewatched Fantastic Four 1, like, twice recently. And he's pretty good in it. Maybe that's why. He's very, like, charismatic. Mm-hmm. The movie is shit. The characters are dumb. But he is, like, the only good one because he's funny.
Yeah, I'll give him that.
He's very funny. And he's all right. Wisecracking. But he's so young.
And that's the thing. He's the completely opposite character in, like, the Captain America movies. He's not the wisecracking guy.
Yeah.
He's super serious. And he does it well.
Mm-hmm. He carries it good.
I still think the original Captain America, where they show him all scrawny.
Oh, my God.
It's really fucking weird.
Yeah. It's so weird. He has,
like, a big head. His body is so, like, tiny.
They put his face on that. So good. It's too funny. I've seen the regular guy next to him.
Yeah.
He does look, like, just as weird with his normal face.
Oh, that's so bad. Okay.
Okay. Well, back to the trailer.
Back to the trailer. They do have that battle at the airport.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Which you can see teams at that point.
Yeah, like, well, but that's the thing with the teams. It didn't look like teams. It looked like everybody on one side and then Iron Man and War Machine.
Iron Man and War Machine and Black Widow.
Whoa, wasn't Black Widow on Evans' team?
No.
Oh, she was on the other side.
She's on the other side.
But Hawkeye was on...
Captain America's team.
So but
that's going to cause a conflict.
Mm-hmm.
Oh,
was Hawkeye. Scarlet Witch also on Iron Man's? I saw her, but I couldn't remember who I saw in the front.
I didn't even
Scarlet Witch. Scarlet Witch is on Captain America's team.
Okay, yeah. Which she can fly now.
Yeah,
that they showed her kind of like using her energy to like pick herself up. That was pretty cool.
Mm-hmm.
Who else did we see? We didn't see any Vision, did we?
No.
Nope.
No Vision at all.
That's a game changer for whoever he's on.
There's no Thor.
Yeah, well, there wouldn't be. He left.
Yeah.
I don't think Vision would take part in this.
Yeah, he'd be neutral, huh?
Yeah, he's just like, this is not my battle. I'm not doing this.
Is Vision, like, supposed to be protector of Earth now? Like, he's, like, Earth's guardian or something?
I don't think so.
Like, what role does he play? Or is he just, like, this omnipotent kind of...
I don't think he's fully, like, omnipotent, but he's just... He's an android trying to... figure stuff out.
Yeah.
I mean, he's still understanding what he is, how people act, how people work.
Would he have like a more of a not a leniency, more of an affinity for Iron Man because in the movies he's coming from Jarvis?
No, he's completely neutral. He has no. He also knows Tony Stark's an asshole.
That's true.
Despite
if anybody knows Tony Stark's an asshole is Jarvis.
Exactly. Yeah. But despite that, I think he still is gonna be like. I lost where I was going with that. Yeah, he would still not take
he's
sides.
He's just going to look at the fight and be like, whoa, hands up in the air, like, I'm not doing this.
Yeah.
Nope. It's a whole can of nope.
Because his role in his mind isn't to settle a dispute between these assholes. It's to do what's better for the world.
Mm-hmm.
This little battle between them is not affecting the world. It's just petty bullshit as far as he's concerned.
Yeah.
Maybe if one went too far, he'd have to come in, but...
Oh, yeah, if it was threatening, like, the lives of millions, yeah, for sure. But it's just them fighting each other, really.
Which kind of, like, downplays the scale of the movie. Like, it looks epic as fuck, but when you think about it, it's not like all the other movies where they're saving the world from something.
Well, I think that's the vein of, like, Captain America movies, minus the first one. Or is that even though there's, like, a lot going on, it's not, like, citywide... destruction or battles. Yeah. It's very small battles.
Well, the first one was kind of like very, it's World War II.
That's why I said minus the first one.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because this one looks like it's still like self-contained.
Yeah.
So it looks pretty cool. And are they fighting each other in the airport?
No, that looks like a, like them fighting each other at the airport.
Maybe they got...
Because like when they show the sides, it's them on like across...
that's true, yeah.
That platform or whatever.
Hmm. A-Man's going to be on Captain America's team, I assume.
Yeah.
Because he's going to help them get Bucky out, so he's probably going to be on their team.
But that's what I seem like. It's not evenly proportional, like the teams. They're not like... Like, it seems like, you know, if you're picking teams for dodgeball,
yeah.
It seems like Captain America gets to pick two people for each time that Iron Man gets to pick one.
Hmm. Maybe his people aren't as strong as Iron Man's?
Scarlet Witch is pretty strong.
Yeah, that's true. She's pretty strong.
He gets Hawkeye, which is negative points.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's not doing shit against all these people with superpowers.
Yeah. He has Ant-Man, who technically could only beat up...
Falcon?
But Falcon's also on.
But he could get into Tony Stark's suit.
He could.
I think he could.
Also probably mess with Bucky's stuff too.
Yeah. But if he's on their side, he wouldn't. But it'd kind of be like he's good enough to where, yeah, he can get in and fuck with your suits. War Machine.
Yeah, so he's actually a pretty valuable guy in that battle.
He can still punch you small and it'll still feel like him as a full size person you. So, I mean, that's good for, like...
Could he get close to Iron Man and War Machine, though? Because I feel like their helmets would be able to, like they'd show him... Even if he shrinks, he's like, no, you're right there.
Maybe,
that's
but
Falcon
if,
did.
If they're in a fight, though, maybe they wouldn't notice him as easily.
Mm.
Not to mention, the way he fights is, you know, as soon as you're taking a punch at him, he shrinks.
Yeah.
He pops up, hits you, shrinks again. It's so much popping around that while you may be able to follow him, he could still surprise you.
Yeah, it's more of a... It's not even so much technological, like... What's the word?
Advanced? I don't know.
I lost it.
But like, I just picture...
Advantage.
Yeah.
It's not a technological advantage in terms of Iron Man, because at that point, it's more his reflexes. He can only... While he does have like the weapons from Iron Man, he still has human reflexes.
Yeah.
Whereas like Captain America, even though he may not be as strong as Iron Man, like weapon-wise, because technically it's just, you know, punching and kicking.
Mm-hmm.
He's not shooting like fucking... cannons out of his hands.
Yeah, true.
But at the same time, his reflexes are a lot better.
Yeah.
Which, towards the end of the trailer, Captain America and Bucky are whooping Iron Man's
ass. Oh my God.
Ass.
Well, before we get to that, the scenes that they show is clearly Bucky going straight for the arc reactor.
Yeah.
In Iron Man's suit, which looks so cool. As he pins him up against the wall, and you can see his fingers really trying to dig in there and pull that out.
Yeah.
And then that goes back to... At the end of that airport fight, Iron Man's holding War Machine, who's like knocked out, and he has his arc reactor pulled out of him.
Mm.
You see the big gaping hole, which you could assume Bucky was like, fuck this, ripped it out and just like probably beat the crap out of him afterwards.
Which there's an advantage that I think that Captain America and Bucky have against Iron Man is, while Iron Man versus Captain America, that might be like, we're friends. I don't really want to do this to you.
Mm-hmm.
Bucky's like, I don't fucking know you. I don't give a fuck.
That's exactly it. Bucky will not like hold back.
Yeah, he'll fucking try to kill Iron Man.
Which is probably going to be the plot twist of the movie.
Yeah.
Because when Bucky tries to kill Tony.
And then Steve's going to be like, no.
What the fuck?
Don't. Like, that's too far.
Like, you can't kill him. I'm beating him down right now so he doesn't kill you.
Yeah.
But you can't kill him either.
That one line, though, where they, it's...
I know what you're saying.
I know. It got me. Where he's like, I can't let you do this. He's my friend.
No, he said, I'm sorry I have to do this, but he's my friend. Something like that.
And then Iron Man goes, I was your friend, too.
He said, so was I.
Yeah.
And he looks so sad. And, like, he has the black eye, and it just looks like...
Like,
man, his eyes look sad, like... Yeah. He's really at that point.
That's why
like,
RDJ gets the money.
He's that point of like, I don't want to have to do this either. But
yeah.
I have to. We have differences, but like, we're still friends.
Exactly. Oh, that's the part that got me.
Oh, man.
When did this movie come out?
May 6th.
Fuck. Too long.
I know. Oh, but okay, now we're going back to that fight. After he says that, and... we're at that fight that like back and forth between Bucky and Captain America is so good. They don't give him a chance to like do anything. You can see even where he like fires his thing from his hand, his laser, and he gets hit at the same time. So you see it miss and it hits the background. As he moves his arm again, he's getting hit from behind. So he's just trying to block someone, but everyone's hitting him in those like spots.
Yeah.
Passing the shield back and forth. See, this is what you need to see Winter Soldier, because they really stepped up Captain America's hand-to-hand combat. Is a lot of good fighting stuff, especially with Winter Soldier. Winter Soldier is just as good as him, like, in that style of fighting. So they're both in sync going back and forth. Like, oh, it's so good. I just can't wait to see that.
I have to go back. I want to watch the first one again, and then I have to watch the second one. And then Age of Ultron against the Age of Ultron can make sense to me.
Yeah. Well, okay, yeah.
It's like there was the whole part about like S.H.I.E.L.D. being part of Hydra?
S.H.I.E.L.D., yeah.
Was like fronting Hydra?
No, Hydra was hiding
in S.H.I.E.L.D.? S.H.I.E.L.D. Okay.
A lot of S.H.I.E.L.D., high-ranking S.H.I.E.L.D. members and low S.H.I.E.L.D. members were part of Hydra.
Okay. Yeah, because that was part of something that like threw me off completely. I was like, what?
Yeah. And you need to see Winter Soldier for that.
Yeah, because I was talking to Maggie about, like, because she was telling me that Age of Ultron made no sense to her. And I asked her, which Marvel movies have you seen? And she's like, I saw all the Iron Man ones. She said, the only ones I haven't seen is the two Thor ones and the two Captain America ones. And I was like, that's all the storyline
for
Age of Ultron.
Like, you don't need the Thor ones, but the Captain America ones.
All you need for Iron Man is Jarvis.
Yeah, but for Thor, you kind of need it for the Infinity Stones, for the like the overall storyline.
Yeah,
not just for like, you know, Civil War or like Age of Ultron, but like because in Age of Ultron, it is the which stone is it?
The Mind Gem.
The Mind Gem. But like that makes more sense if you realize that there's the theme of the stones throughout the.
Yeah, that's true. Ah, man, we need to go back to Avengers. I need to rewatch that.
Age of Ultron.
Yeah.
So we watch all the Avengers and then talk about this.
Yeah, all two.
How many movies is that now? Okay,
there's only two Avengers.
No, I thought like the whole Marvel universe.
No,
that's too many. There's three Captain Americas, Thor, two Thors,
three Iron Mans.
Hey, at least
I already counted that.
At least there's no relevant Hulk movies.
There's one Hulk movie, The Incredible Hulk.
Yeah,
it's not relevant to this though.
Yeah, it is. It's part of the story. That's part of the thing. Just they switched actors, but.
Oh, I the Hulk. Since I switched actors, it was just an entire reboot.
No. That was part of like.
Because remember, he was continuity. Mentioning the general. The general from the Hulk is coming back into this.
Oh, yeah. Okay, that's right.
He's also the same general at the end of Iron Man 2.
Where he says, we're assembling a team?
Where he comes to Tony Stark and he's like, yeah, we're assembling this team. We need.
No. Tony Stark comes to the general at the end of the Hulk.
Yes, you're right. That's what it is. Tony Stark going to the general.
We have one Hulk. We have three Iron Mans. We're going to have three Captain Americas.
Two Thors.
Fuck, that's already nine movies.
That is
Guardians of the Galaxy.
Guardians.
Are we missing any?
Guardians doesn't tie in with the Avengers stuff, though. And the two Avengers movies.
No, but if you're talking just Marvel.
But the overall arc, it's eventually going to merge together.
It'll get there somewhere.
I watched Guardians last week, actually.
Yeah. I love Guardians.
Me too.
It's so good.
Yeah.
I think it's the best Marvel movie that came out so far.
Yeah.
Last year, I was so torn between Guardians and Winter Soldier because they were both really good. Two completely different things.
Yeah.
One was more serious and like drama.
Yeah.
And the other one was very like comedy, action, and completely different, but both really, really good.
I'm going to have to
still say Guardians.
I'm too stuck. I loved them both so much. I can't even compare them.
I do have to watch Winter Soldier.
But they're good.
But I don't know.
You'll probably like Guardians more. Because it's such a fun, good time.
It's not just that. It's
emotion, like
yeah,
yeah.
It's such a good Marvel movie, and just on its own, it's such a good movie.
It is. It could be completely on its own, and it would still work.
Yeah,
they like made you cry, and then the rest of the movie was goofy.
Oh yeah,
they're just all like, "Fuck your feelings."
I was laughing the whole time during Guardians, except for three moments where I was like choking back tears, and I was like,
"The beginning,
my man, I can't cry."
When he saves Gamora.
Yeah, the beginning.
Oh yeah,
Gamora.
And we are Groot.
Yeah, oh, and the Groot scene. Oh my God.
That was the one that like got me. Like you said, the first scene, I was like, no, this movie got way too real, way too quick.
It's so real in the very beginning. You're just like,
it just came out of nowhere.
Why did you start this way?
It comes out talking about sadness, and then the
then he's dancing through this fucking space planet. Yeah. You're like, what
kicking little monsters.
It's a roller coaster of emotion.
Explaining how his ship under blacklight will be like a Jackson Pollock painting.
I forgot about that one.
Oh, that movie's too amazing all the way through.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I can't wait for the second one. I really can't.
Yeah, it's gonna be great.
Where they go after, like, are they gonna go into his dad?
They're supposed to. Yeah.
Oh, I can't wait. I'd like just like that extended universe, not so much like the Marvel universe itself, just the Guardians extended universe.
I love the space universe. Yes, that's the coolest stuff to me.
There's so much in it though. Like that's what, like, that's the same thing I like about Star Wars, is that it's technically infinite.
Mm-hmm.
Like, because it is space, you could literally just make up a planet, fuck it, and just have a storyline before that planet.
I read an article that was talking about how Bradley Cooper put out a spoiler about Star-Lord's father or something like that in an interview.
Oh, what?
And it was like a big-ass, like, super, you know, important article or whatever. And the next day, James Gunn tweeted something about it, and he was just like, dude, I just gave Bradley Cooper the script yesterday. Like, he doesn't know shit. He knows nothing. I just gave him the script. He doesn't know anything. He hasn't even read all the way through it yet.
Nice. That's fucking great.
He just straight up is like, nah.
So is that Bradley Cooper just trolling everybody?
I think so.
Nice. Okay. Have we gone over most of the trailer then?
I think we've pretty much gone over it.
Yeah.
Bucky, okay. Well, did I say that I think Bucky is going to be a big, like, point of this movie?
Mm-hmm.
More than anything else?
I think
of course he is. That's the focus is Bucky. Is everyone's trying to kill Bucky, and he's trying.
He's
to,
the
like,
main catalyst.
Everyone.
Yeah,
yeah.
Like while
Steve's
the
trying to convince everyone, like, no, he's not.
He's not bad. Yeah. But the thing too is that he was a bad person.
He killed a lot of fucking people.
And it's like, even though the idea of civil war is supposed to be around the Accords, it's not the trigger. It's not like the catalyst of everything coming together. Like, there's a bit of tension because of the whole political shit,
mm-hmm.
but it's not the main thing that everybody goes, what the fuck, guys?
Yeah. Now I'm curious, too. What are they going to do about Bucky? I mean, he's a good person now, but he did a lot of bad stuff.
Well, that's the thing. Captain America's the one that's like, it's okay, we can forgive you. And everyone else is like, no, dude, he's got to stand trial.
Well, even, like, once Tony finds out that, like, it was Winter Soldier that probably killed his parents.
Mm-hmm.
And that's a whole nother level of fucking, I hate this guy.
It's kind of the same argument that I would say is for Vegeta and DBZ. Because Vegeta
did a lot of stuff. Shit.
He killed like a whole city of people when they first came to Earth.
That is true.
He's killed a lot of people. Not to mention his whole, like, 18 years leading up to when he got to Earth of just slaughtering people.
Yeah.
Which is why in, like, I think one of the movies, when, like, everybody comes back from, it's like after everybody dies in the afterlife, Vegeta doesn't go to heaven. He goes to hell.
You're right. That just shows accountability.
Yeah.
That even though everyone forgave him or doesn't care, it still doesn't matter.
He still goes to hell.
Yeah. Well, anyway, I guess that's pretty much it. We've covered the trailer now.
Okay. So let's go into our own versus matches.
Yeah.
Let's do this.
Let's do our own civil war.
We should pause here, though, and take a break before we do that.
Why?
Because I have to pee really bad.
Okay, then. We'll be back after these messages. Hi, welcome to Shooting Blanks Entertainment. I'm Kramer, and I'm here to tell you about Audible.com. Audible.com.
Hello. Hey.
Hey, I'm sorry.
Hi, is this...
How'd you get in here?
Is this Lenny's?
No.
No, this isn't Lenny's.
How'd you get into the studio? Who let you in?
Studio? I was looking for a sandwich.
No, I don't have a sandwich.
A sandwich? That's not true. What you were just... You weren't taking my order? Just right now?
No. I need you to leave. We're trying to do a commercial here for audible.com.
But my pastrami.
No. Pastrami? Who eats pastrami still? Nobody eats pastrami.
Everyone eats pastrami. It's delicious.
This isn't fucking New Jersey in 1940s. Nobody eats pastrami anymore.
You put it on some rye, you don't know what you're missing.
Sir, I'm trying to do a commercial here for audible.com. I'm going to need you to leave.
What is audible.com? Oh, yes. That's that thing my grandson gave me when he didn't want to read to me in the home anymore.
Why can't you read it?
since my eyesight, you know, went. It's a long story. Do you really want to hear it?
Sure. Why not?
Well, you see, I was involved some hookers. Okay.
Whoa!
I wasn't always the best in my youth.
Uh huh.
And I was cranking my stuff, and I just lost my vision.
You just lost it?
You know the old saying, if you masturbate a little too much, it's not entirely untrue. I found. At least the doctors, you know.
So what you're telling me is that you went to the doctors after you went blind, and they said that it was from masturbating too much.
Yeah, and the only time I can think of is that last time there was Stacy and Cinnamon, and then I don't remember being able to see anything very much after that.
And now you use Audible?
My grandson, he decided one day he just didn't have the time to come read to me anymore.
And so did you go on audible.com?
He went on for me, and what do you call it when you save the thing and you just have to click on it?
There's a trial, the thing you can do. When you sign up, you go to audibletrial.com/shootingblanks, which is our promo code, and you can get a free audiobook.
A free one?
Yeah.
I've been paying for them this whole time.
Nah, you get a free one with us. It'll be on us. I'm glad you came in here, actually.
Jerry!
Sir?
Did you get the sandwiches?
They don't have the sandwiches.
Why don't they? I want the pastrami.
I told them about the pastrami.
Nobody's pastrami.
Look here, pastrami is the best.
No.
I told them about the pastrami, and he looked at me like I was crazy.
Get the fuck out of here. Get out of my studio.
Is it on rye bread?
It is quite excellent. Life-changing, maybe.
Nice. I'm jealous.
The most...
I hope to pee like that one day.
I hope never have to pee like that again.
Was it an epiphany? I hate myself for that one.
Now I'm legitimately laughing. Not bad. All right, okay, segue.
Back to versus matches.
Versus!
Since we're coming off of Captain America versus Iron Man, let's keep Captain America and throw in Master Chief.
Yeah, Super Soldier. Versus Super Soldier. I think he's called a Spartan.
Yeah, he's a Spartan.
Which, he's a Super Soldier?
Yes.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah. I like that pause, but it was like you ended that sentence in a question. He's a Super Soldier.
You know. Huh? Yeah. Right? All right, guys.
Okay.
Okay.
Let's spin off, like, right off the bat, who we think would win.
Right off the back. Okay.
Off the back?
Off the back. Off the back of Harrison Ford.
I'm going to say...
What?
I'm going to say Captain America.
I'm going to say Master Chief.
I'm also going to say Captain America, because that was my first choice. But now I started thinking Master Chief, but I'm going to go with my gut.
Though Master Chief is larger in size.
Yeah.
And has armor.
Isn't he like 8 feet tall?
Yeah, he's pretty huge.
He's a fucking giant.
Yeah.
Really, his skills are limited to weapons. Which Captain America obviously is. He's not getting shot. If he hasn't got shot by now, he's not getting shot.
But there's he's so. But that's shield. Like just regular like guns. He doesn't get shot by like giant fucking that
lasers.
Fucking alien rocket launchers that shoot giant lasers.
See, what I was thinking is that Master Chief is all about guns and weapons,
mm-hmm.
and Captain America can disable a gun. And, like, he's better at hand-to-hand combat. So all he has to do is get a gun out of his hand, and he would just beat the crap out of him.
Captain America won World War II. World War II.
But are we going to do it where Captain America versus Master Chief, like, in a ring fight? Or is it, we're going to start them off, huh?
Why would it ever be a ring fight? No epic battle like this is going to happen in a ring.
The way I imagined the fight would be was you just drop them off in a jungle. On either side.
Predator style?
Predator style.
Yeah, definitely.
Exactly. That's how I imagine the match going.
You know what? I listened to a lot of Versus Match on another podcast, and there's scenarios that you're in a football field with whatever you would normally have with you, and you have to fight each other.
That's how I see it happening. It'd like, just be like a
no
field.
Distractions. You're just there. And Master Chief probably has a gun, whatever weapons he can carry. And the same thing with Captain America.
Whatever weapons he can carry?
Yeah. Whatever weapons he normally carries.
Okay, yeah.
Oh, okay. And then, so it would just be like, I guess, the Desert Eagle and the assault rifle.
Yeah.
Sure. I don't know enough about Master Chief, okay? I'm not a
big Halo fan. Sure, basic loading.
Yeah. Okay.
And then Captain America just has the shield. That's all he ever has.
Yeah.
Which he's proven time and time again. And if you shoot at him, he's just going to deflect it.
He'll block it with the shield. That's but true. Can his shield is indestructible. So I don't think the lasers and stuff would like hurt it.
Vibranium can deflect lasers?
It's vibranium and something else. Well, they don't have lasers.
Master Chief wouldn't have lasers in a regular loadout, though. Only plasma stuff he gets is from
the other the aliens, yeah.
So
you have no alien tech. Just
no alien tech? Okay, if we take away alien tech and it's just a head-on-head fight, nah, Captain America wins.
I think so. It'd be too... Captain America would start off... They'd start off being across from each other. I assume Master Chief would start shooting at him. Captain America would run towards him with the shield, holding it, blocking his face and stuff. Get close enough, throw the shield at him, maybe hit him in the neck or something.
And as soon as Master Chief looks back up,
Captain America's in his face,
of him, just wailing at
him. Bam, punching through his mask, ripping, I don't know, maybe trying to rip his suit off.
Master Chief isn't fast, per se.
No.
He's like just a walking tank.
Yeah, he's just really big and strong, and he can shoot decently.
Yeah. Yeah.
In none of the Halo games does he ever move with any sort of swiftness. That was my biggest beef with the Halo games is
the newer ones he has shit. The newer ones he has a dash option. Like where you can dash for short periods of time. Mm. Which he's actually pretty fucking fast, but it's still not Captain America fast.
Yeah.
I think he would have like similar strength as Captain America. Is that like correct?
Yeah, probably
pretty. Like he'd probably be just as strong as him, but I think Captain America is a more seasoned fighter. Like straight hand to hand.
Okay, yeah, straight hand to hand.
I picture Master Chief. He's a badass fighter with a gun and like warfare style. Like everything's coming at you.
Yeah,
and they do still do like he stabs people, right? Like you can hit people with your hand. I think.
Yeah, you can still like just
like if you don't have a weapon, you can just like punch someone.
Yeah,
and
which I love doing, just hitting people with the end of rifles.
I could see him like doing something like that, but because Captain America is a little more like good at combat hand to hand style, he could like. Maybe block that type of like butt end of a gun.
I just imagined what if like, and I know this isn't like for the match. I just want to know what would happen if like Captain America ran at Master Chief with the shield up and he's about to do something because he sees like Master Chief is about to swing something.
Yes.
But he doesn't know what it is because he's never seen this before.
Go on.
Master Chief swings out the gravity hammer.
Whoa.
And hits against the shield. The shields and Captain America aren't just going to stay there. He would go flying.
He would fly him, yeah,
super far back. Wasn't there a scene where Thor hit Captain America's shield? I think it was...
In Age of Ultron?
I don't remember. I think there was a point where he hit...
I think it was the original Avengers.
Yeah, I think where he hit the shield with the hammer.
Yeah, because they arrest Loki, and then Thor shows up.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's when they're fighting in the forest... Iron Man, Captain America, and Thor.
I totally forgot about that scene.
He hits the shield and he's just like, it makes this huge like...
Boom. Like shock attack?
Yeah,
like shock. Airwave just...
Yeah.
It doesn't break the shield, right?
No.
But does it push Iron Man back? Or
it
not
pushes
Iron Man.
Everybody back. They all get blasted in all directions.
So it'd probably be the same thing with the Warhammer.
Yeah, wasn't that what ended the fight?
Or Gravity Hammer.
That's what they ended the fight, right? Whenever he hit it and they all went blasting in different directions and they were like, shit, why are we fighting?
Yeah, that sounds right.
They're like, whoa, guys, we need to calm down.
Yeah, this is serious. I don't know what just happened, but this messed up all of us.
Okay. How strong is Master Chief's armor?
It's pretty fucking strong.
Yeah, it's pretty strong.
Like, he can fall out of a spaceship. And, like, no, that happened for the beginning of Halo 3. Mm-hmm. Yeah. It starts after he's fallen out of a spaceship and hit the planet.
Holy shit.
Yeah, he just wakes up in a crater.
Wow. So now I'm starting to think, okay, if Captain America can get around him, how much damage can he inflict on him without, like, the shield? Like, with his hands or something? If he's thrown the shield and it's hit him...
It's still going to take quite a few hits.
It would have to be mostly the shield that does it.
I think so. He'd have to have it and just be, like, hacking away at him with the shield to get through some of that armor.
Yeah, because for what I'm imagining is if, like, Captain America jumps out and he's doing, like, that punch he does with the shield.
Yeah, yeah.
If, like...
That's what I was picturing.
If Master Chief just grabs it and, like... swings,
throws the shield with him, like attached to it.
No. Oh. He manages to hold onto the shield and swings with the shield, mm-hmm. and Captain America flies out of it. Mm-hmm. His arm comes loose from the shield.
Oh yeah,
and then so Captain America flies across and he lands and he's like, oh shit, I don't have my shield. And Master Chief doesn't know what it is, so he's gonna be like,
discards it.
Yeah, just tosses it to the side, and then go hand to hand.
What if he knew what it was and he's now has the shield?
I don't know. I don't think
Master Chief has any training with a shield.
He doesn't seem to have, but he has. He can use just about any weapon that he comes across. Even if he's like, I don't know what this weapon is. I've never, my species has never seen this in my life.
Oh man.
I guess
I picture Master Chief even if it falls on the floor, just picking it up because it's a weapon and holding onto it, and just like, well, I guess I'll use it, and just knocking Steve Rogers in the head and knocking him out or something.
I kind of have a feeling though, like if Master Chief does get him down and he, for example, just like steps on his chest,
mm-hmm.
there's no way he's lifting that armor off of him.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Like if
I assume the armor and himself are very heavy.
It's got to be.
Yeah. No, if you could survive from space falling. When
you hear him take a step, it's
damn. Oh, this got a little more interesting. Maybe Master Chief does have an upper hand here.
He's definitely got an even match, but I still think that Captain America would come on top.
What if Captain America could break his face, his little face mask or something?
You know, I think the Spartans, and they show it in...
Is Master Chief Phantom of the Opera, where he never shows his face because it's disfigured?
No, I think he has a baby face.
A baby face.
Because I haven't played a lot of the more recent Halo games.
Mm-hmm.
But in the beginning of
him and Steve Rogers gonna have a baby face off.
What is it?
Gonna look at each other.
I wanted to say North Till Dawn, but North Till Dawn is the local rock band. It's not. What is that? That miniseries they had for Halo.
Forward onto Dawn.
Yeah. And they show a lot of the Spartans show up and start helping everybody out.
Mm-hmm.
But when they take off their masks, it's like little kid masks. Because the Spartans are like, I think they start developing them when they're kids. Mm-hmm. And I'm probably completely wrong about this.
Probably.
But when they take off their masks, they look like kids. They have like kid faces.
They all got baby faces.
So you think they may be...
But his voice is all deep.
I didn't say anything about their voices. It's just like he opens it up and it just looks
like a kid pumped with too much testosterone.
McCullen from the Home Alone.
Oh, you'll call it Coke. Yeah, what's his name?
Kevin.
It looks like Kevin, like from
Kevin McAllister.
He just looks like Kevin from the Home Alone movies. It just has that face and he's like, what are you doing here?
This is my house.
Oh, I want that line.
Do you think they're ever going to show his face?
I doubt it.
Probably not, because he's a symbol.
Because with what they did, I think they kind of put themselves into a box with making all the other Spartans have baby faces, but having him have a really deep voice, they're like, there's no way we could post this, because if we make this happen, no one's going to take it seriously.
Well,
I want to say it's evenly matched up until a certain point, but I want to say you guys are right that Captain America might come out on top. But it will be a good fight.
Yeah, it would. I could see that being really awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'd still say Captain America then.
Okay.
I just want Captain America to throw the shield into his neck.
Yeah.
And just have it bounce back. Just keep throwing it. Just keep throwing it into his neck and taking him out.
Now, having said that, I think it's a good one-on-one fight. Mm-hmm. But if they were to if we were doing Predator style.
Like in the jungles?
Like in the jungles, I want to say Master Chief might come out on top. If we throw in all available options for them,
mm-hmm.
which for Captain America doesn't really increase his options much, but with Master Chief, it includes invisibility cloaks,
mm-hmm.
all the different weapons. I want to say the sword. I don't think it could cut through the shield.
No, it'd probably
the plasma sword.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, Captain America would just have to fight guerrilla style. Just using wooden traps and and holes in the ground with spikes.
But that's Master Chief's specialty, is fighting on alien planets and alien jungles.
Yeah.
So if it was Predator style...
There'd have to be stuff where he'd find and pick up.
Yeah, I want to say in Predator style, Master Chief might have a small upper hand.
What if Predator's there and he steals Predator weapons?
Oh.
Predator's the alien planet, and Master Chief.
He just finds Predator and kills Predator.
And Master Chief and like Captain America get thrown on the planet, and they're supposed to fight each other, but they come across the Predator.
Yeah, they don't know he's there. Until yeah, there,
he's invisible, but they like can clearly see him.
I need this movie to happen.
You know how many times they could rehash this movie with different characters and just the Predator in a jungle?
This is true. I like that.
It's very good.
I would watch... It'd be like the Godzilla movie.
I'd want the Predator to get killed every time. It's not about him, but he's always there.
Yes.
Like Jason?
He doesn't have to die. He has to get hurt. And then every day, every time the movie starts, you find out he's finally... It's been a couple of years. He's finally back to good health, looking through his jungle. And then they drop two more guys, and he's like, God damn it.
Yes, I don't want this to happen. I want this to be like a mini series on TV, but in straight head on head, in a giant like
in a field.
Yeah, in a field, a big open field with basic options. Yeah. Captain America.
Yeah, I'd say that too.
Yep, I'm going with Captain America.
Woo. All because of the shield.
Yeah.
Yeah.
If he lost the shield, though, he'd probably get murdered.
Mm.
I think so. Imagine just getting punched with. His armored fist.
Yeah, I want to say
he wears no other protection.
Yeah, I want to say if like Master Chief manages to pry off the shield,
ooh,
then no, Captain America's done.
Yeah,
I could see maybe an instance of him throwing the shield and then Master Chief just catching it.
Yeah,
just like Winter Soldier.
Oh,
just what if? Yeah, what if he throws the shield and if Bucky could catch it, Master Chief could catch it.
He just dodge out of the way. Damn.
Yeah, I just see him like lifting his hand, just boom, grasp, like catching it and catching.
Not
America
even by like the handle, but just by the edge of it.
By the edge of it, yeah, yeah, just doom.
He just like he somehow attaches it to his armor, and then pulls out a rifle, and then Steve Rogers is like, "Fuck."
Well, in Avengers, you see it has some kind of magnetic clip now.
Oh,
that's how he keeps it like attached to him. And at one point, I think he kicks it, and it flips up, and it snaps to his arm.
Mm.
He's just going to be like, chink, I have the shield now.
What if he, like, what if whenever he goes to catch it, he puts his arm up to like to block it, but it just snaps to his arm, and he's just like...
wiggling his arm, like...
Then he realizes it's there, and he's just like, whatever.
Cortana's like,
I guess this is
I did a quick, quick check. This is really good for us.
Armor increased by 40%, Chief.
Yes.
All right.
Well, all right then.
That's pretty good.
And then Steve Rogers is just like, shit.
You know what? I'm going to change my answer to Master Chief just for that. Because now I can picture Steve Rogers' go-to move is to throw the shield, and he catches it, and then he's like, fuck.
Oof.
So I'm going to go with Master Chief because of that. I can't get over how great that is.
All right.
Oh, man, that's so good. Oh, man. Okay, next one. What do we got next? Next versus match.
And do the two guys that change into things?
I
forgot which ones we were going with.
Oh, Bruce Banner and the Hulk versus Aaron Yeager. And Aaron's Titan form from Attack on Titan.
Da-na-na-na-na. First, without thinking,
Hulk.
First off the back,
Hulk.
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 Stryker.
Prior to changing, Aaron's obviously more of a badass.
Yes.
Yeah.
So if it came down to them meeting in a fight before they change, Aaron might just kill him before.
Yeah. Especially if he has the 3D maneuver gear and the blades.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Which you know he's asked to have.
Which Bruce Banner is sitting there with.
He's going to have a lab coat.
He has a beaker in one hand. That's his weapon, a glass beaker.
His glasses.
And a Bunsen burner.
don't come over here. There may be a chemical in this beaker.
Don't make me do science.
You know what? He would probably amaze Aaron with his science. They don't have that kind of science in Attack on Titan world. He would be like, look, I'm doing science. He'd be like, oh. That is really interesting. And then, bam, he'd squish him.
Watch as I put this baking soda into my little volcano.
Yeah, he just makes like, a little volcano. He's like,
a little. No, because they don't know anything about volcanoes.
Exactly. They'd be so like,
is
whoa.
That river fire?
What is this kind of sorcery? And as Aaron's like freaking out over this volcano, he turns into the Hulk, walks behind him. Yeah, he just grabs those little beakers and smacks it over him in the face. Glass shards all in his eye. He flips the volcano into his face, burns him with the Bunsen burner.
But you also have to take into effect Mikasa,
who is going to be there. You know what? She will have to be there.
Because no matter what the rules are, Mikasa's going to break the rules if she feels Eren's in trouble.
Yeah, this is true.
She's always going to be there.
She's just, you know what? If it was, I'm thinking football field again. If it was the football field, she'd be hiding behind the goalposts the whole time.
Under the bleachers. Yes. And in the announcer tower, she's like where the announcer guys sit. She's just sitting there looking through the glass.
Exactly. Like, she's just waiting for it.
She's gonna be like in like the second or was the first episode of Attack on Titan when when those bullies are picking on Armin and they see Eren running and they're like, hey, it's Eren. We'll kick his ass too. And they look behind and they see Mikasa's running. They're like, oh shit,
yeah.
We need to get the fuck out of here. Bruce Banner's going to be doing that. He's going to look up and see her eyes and just be like,
as the match starts and they start running at each other, nothing's happened yet. They're just running at each other. Armin is still on the bleachers with like a fucking Eren flag. A
little Eren flag.
He's like, no, Eren! No! Eren!
You know what? My original answer, I was going to say the Hulk because he's more control. But because of Mikasa...
Well, once they transform...
Once they okay, let's just say Eren's not amazed by this science trick. Decides to turn into a Titan. Hulk turns, or Bruce Banner turns into the Hulk. Eren's way bigger than him.
He is.
But I have a feeling the Hulk is stronger than him.
The Hulk has taken on something that size before.
But Eren has a lot more acute fighting sense. The Hulk's just kind of like smash, punch things.
This is true.
Aaron's a calculated fighter.
Eren can actually, like, he can fight.
If he has control of it, he has military training.
Yeah.
Granted, it's when he was 16, but it's still military training.
It's still there. He's not too much older.
14.
And he was beating down 2 or 3 Titans at a time, like, all attacking him.
That's true.
But the Hulk is also a good enough fighter. Not, like actual, like, combat style, but he can, like, fight. I mean, in Ultron, he's ripping apart... You know, he's swarmed by the robots and he's just ripping them to shreds.
And Eren has that healing factor.
Eren does have the healing factor that Titans have. But Hulk is super, not indestructible, but like, he's pretty indestructible.
He's getting blasted by tanks. And
he can get shot at by lasers and...
Titans are penetrated by steel.
Yeah. Titans can still, they take a lot more damage than the Hulk would.
But they do regenerate, so they could still keep going. The Hulk would have to continuously.
The Hulk would have to rip at him.
Well, not necessarily. You can still disable a Titan temporarily. Like you can take out its knees and legs and stuff.
Which
like
has happened. His what was it? Did his legs get like chopped off at one point? And he's just lying there waiting for them to like grow back.
Well,
his hands. When he's punching a Titan, he basically punches his hand off.
Yeah. He was fighting Annie.
Yeah,
and he was holding his neck, waiting for himself to regenerate. Right.
No, that was her.
No, that was her. Because
she was holding her
eyes. Oh, yeah, yeah.
They take out her eyes.
Yeah.
She's holding her neck because she knows, that's her spot. Which he wouldn't know the weak spot, but I assume the Hulk would just keep, punching him.
Could he through the Titan until he gets to Eren and then pull him out?
Yeah, he could.
He could, yeah. I could see him definitely climbing up him and ripping him out of the neck.
Yeah.
Especially if Eren goes to try to eat him. There's no way he's, going to kill the Hulk inside. Because the Hulk's pretty much indestructible. He can't be penetrated by bullets.
Yeah.
He's not going to be penetrated by teeth.
Mm-hmm.
Even if he got swallowed, I think he would burst out the stomach Alien.
Yeah. Kind of like Eren did.
Yeah.
And even if they're in the human forms, if they attack each other, because Bruce Banner, as soon as his body is in danger, it just bursts into the Hulk.
That is true. That's why he couldn't kill himself.
Yeah, because he tried to before.
Yeah, and he says the Hulk stopped the bullet.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, even if Eren was charging at him and he didn't want to transform, as soon as his blade would even, get close to him, I think he would transform.
Yeah.
So, if, the Hulk, if Bruce Banner gets a paper cut, does he turn into the Hulk?
He's like, God damn it! just crushing paper?
It probably started that way. I guess that's what he was talking about in the Avengers movie when he was saying, I stay angry. Yeah, so that these little things are, just annoyances.
I'm always angry, yeah.
If I stub my toe, I'm not going to freak out. As, one of us probably would. We'd get pissed and, smash a shelf or something.
Yeah, that's true.
God damn it.
I'm going to give this one to the Hulk.
I'd say so, too.
Also,
but
Eren in Titan form gets tired.
Yeah.
He loses control slowly over time. Because they even, in the manga, later as they go on, they do experiments to see how long he can stay in Titan form.
Mm-hmm.
And, his rest periods aren't as often, and, he gets tired quicker. Whereas the Hulk, as far as we know, just keeps going.
Yeah.
There's no stopping the Hulk.
I think at some point, if they make him transform back to back too many times, he starts getting, like, dumber. Like, he doesn't know anything.
Yeah, Aaron? Yeah.
Yeah.
Although, I imagine it would just need the initial transformation.
Yeah. But I could see the Hulk, like, ripping his mouth off or something.
Yeah, the Hulk would definitely get in there and find him inside of the Titan.
I imagine him just, like...
Yeah.
Is it Avengers where he's just, like, he takes down a ship and he's just ripping it apart? I could see him just doing that to, like, Aaron.
Yeah, just pummeling it until he gets...
Yes, just pummeling it, seeing he can cause damage and just keep at it.
And like you were saying, if he just fights him, he's going to eventually, even with the healing factor, mm-hmm. it's not that fast.
No.
He would just start ripping him piece by piece, and it's not going to like have time to heal.
If you keep going at it, it'll never heal.
It'd be like Walking Dead style. You'd just be tearing him apart.
Yeah. That'd be really cool. Man, I would watch this.
Yeah. These are good fights.
Yeah. I like that.
I think Hulk unanimously has this one.
Yeah. I'd give that to Hulk, too.
Definitely.
Master Chief and... Captain America, I feel it goes either way.
It can, depending on the circumstances.
Yeah.
Just whatever you want it to happen. Yeah. But this one's a little, I wouldn't say one-sided, but...
It's still a good fight, but it's still going to end the same way.
I would love to see, like, Aaron reaching down to, like, hit the Hulk, like, with his hand, like, trying to squish him, and the Hulk, like, catching the hand, still being pushed into the ground, like, grabbing his fist and, like...
It's like throwing the Titan.
If he could throw the Titan, it would be awesome. But I could see it at least just like pushing it off, like out of him.
Or just like shoving his hand to the side when he like stumbles down forward, uppercutting him.
Yes.
Oh,
doing one of those giant like Hulk leaps and just brah. Or even the way of like in Avengers 2 where he's like, the way he climbs the buildings, you know, he just leaping at him and stuff. Like just doing that to Aaron. But as he's doing it, he's like ripping parts of his like skin off to jump higher and higher to him and then just smacking him in the face.
Well, I want
to
see a part where like he's grabbing the Titan and the Titan grabs him off of his chest, holds it in front of him and does that giant like this Titan scream.
Yeah.
And then Hulk just screams back.
Oh.
And like the Titan,
his arms all constricted and then just busts out of his fist.
Yeah. But even when he screams at him, the Titan's head like gets knocked back from the scream. Because even the Hulk scream is powerful.
Yeah.
Could we... Oh, man.
Scream Off?
No.
Who's the best metalcore singer? Hulk or Titan?
Y'all guys haven't got far enough in the Attack on Titan manga that I can't say how he could do something...
I haven't read any of it.
...that would be kind of cool against the Hulk. I could tell you.
Well, because a lot of our listeners also haven't read the manga.
What if they have?
Come on.
It's been out for a long time. The show's been over for a year.
For a lot of things, haven't been out for a long time.
This one's been out for a while. It's a really good part. Can I spoilers?
No,
can I
just no Attack on Titan spoilers.
Okay, fine.
The new season comes out this summer, doesn't it?
Maybe. We don't know.
It might.
They have not announced
good
it.
Good enough.
Fine.
Okay.
Because of this part, it would have been like, it would have gave the Hulk a little trouble.
It still
but I can't
Hulk,
do
though.
It, so I guess not.
But even if I don't know what it is, still be the Hulk.
That's not fair. If you won't let me say it, you can't say the Hulk would win that part.
Okay. Because we don't know everything about Titans yet, we can say that it's still open-ended. However, if we're going just by, because we normally throw out books whenever we're discussing stuff.
I have never remembered that.
What are we doing about the dating? We remember like who we would date. We didn't even discuss books.
Are we talking about the phrase throwing out the book?
What?
You know how like cops use it?
No. You don't throw out the book. You throw the book at them.
I thought you throw out the book when you want to be a rebel.
No, you throw the book at them.
No, that's when you want to prosecute them to the highest.
Yeah,
you're throwing the book at them. But when you want to do your own thing and go rogue, you throw out the book.
I thought that was called being Batman.
No, it's called throwing out the book.
That was called being Batman.
No, he does his own no matter what.
Batman doesn't have the book. He can't read.
God damn it. That's why he has so much money. Doesn't know how to read. He never has to read. Okay, fine. So anyway.
Okay.
Hulk would still win.
Yeah. Next match.
Even what I said, I don't think it would have changed it too much, but it would have been an interesting thing.
It would have been a good fight.
Yeah.
Okay, next match.
Next match, we're going to do Speedsters.
The Flash versus Sonic the Hedgehog.
Versus Sanic.
Sanic.
You haven't seen that? Dumb meme.
Yeah.
He looks all fucked up.
Danky King.
Danky King. Sanic.
It's still my battle cry. I beat Maggie in Uno, and I screamed out "Dake Care" because it started beating my chest. I didn't even scream out Uno. I was like, "Dake Care." She was not happy about it.
You know not happy about it now. Made her happy.
Okay.
According to the rules of the game, if she would have said Uno, you lose.
That's true.
I bet she's more angry now that she didn't know that.
Okay.
Sonic versus the Flash. First off, I'd go with the Flash.
Yeah. Yeah.
They're fast, but I don't know why.
Wait. Are they fighting? Or are they just racing?
They're fighting. They're doing whatever they do.
We don't have to make this a fight. If it's two speedsters, I want to race.
Well, we don't have clocked speeds on either one of them, so.
Can Sonic go around the world really fast? Like the Flash can?
And if you're going on
speed. Or does Sonic only go fast for gold?
Well, if you're going off speed too, you can also factor in Superman.
Yeah, well, because the Flash and Superman, they race in one episode and they're going the same speed.
Mm-hmm.
Can Sonic run over water?
What if they just fight?
The Flash can run over water.
I've seen Sonic run over water in the cartoon series.
Okay.
The animated series.
Sonic is Jesus.
But what if there's... excuse me. What if there's... Because Sonic can go through like loops and like he's very good at jumping. Can the Flash jump? Well,
I assume it's just the speed momentum that takes you through the loops.
Well, but even like he can still jump,
but he turns into a ball.
Can the Flash do obstacles well?
Mm-hmm.
Can the Flash parkour?
Not at that speed, I don't think.
He'd
be going way too fast.
I think he just runs over things. He doesn't necessarily.
It just like runs through the mountains.
Yeah,
I think he can run up stuff.
Yeah, he can do vertical runs.
That's okay. Close.
Yeah, that's good enough.
Yeah?
Yeah. Okay, I'm going to give it to the Flash on this one.
Yeah, I picture Sonic turning into a little ball and the Flash just punting the shit out of him.
Yeah.
He'd be going so fast that he could just hit him and Sonic would never stop, like, ever. He would just keep flying and somehow go into space and maybe into the sun.
Maybe into the sun.
Yeah, the Flash would probably win.
Okay. Well, that was pretty set up pretty quickly.
I don't know. Sonic doesn't have sharp little things on him like a normal hedgehog, except for his funny hair.
And even then, the hedgehogs, they're not really that sharp. They're not like a porcupine.
No, they're not.
They're just little cute creatures.
Yeah. I don't know.
They'd eat their own poop.
I'm trying to expand this, but it's too easy.
It's the Flash.
If he lost for whatever reason or was going to lose, he would just run fast enough and go back in time. Maybe he'd put like gold rings into a trap. And then Sonic would be chasing these little rings and the floor would give way and there'd be spikes and he would die.
When I was younger, I always imagined those as SpaghettiOs.
It was the story of Sonic like the Sonic Hungry Hedgehog.
Sonic the Hungry Hedgehog. He just runs after SpaghettiOs.
He's just trying to eat his children's pasta soup.
Yes.
His children are dead, so he's trying to live their memory of just eating their favorite soup over and over.
That's all it is Sonic's dreams, or a father's dreams of himself being a hedgehog chasing after his children's favorite meal.
And Dr. Robotnik is his former owner.
Dr. Robotnik is the man that killed his children.
Oh. Mm.
I was going to make it more like the Trix Rabbit, where he's just a hedgehog who really likes the SpaghettiOs.
It's just a hedgehog with an addiction.
Yeah.
And he's always looking for gold to buy his addiction.
Yes.
I like that. That works.
Poor Sonic.
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 Okay.
Well, yeah.
Sonic. I think, is that it for the death matches for now? Or?
Yeah, for now. Where are we at? Good time?
Yeah, we're well over time, yeah.
Oh, well, all right then.
We always pass time. We never... I think the goal for all these is supposed to be like an hour. The last one was 2 hours and 30 minutes. The
last one was a big exception. Yeah, but we'll save some more for another time.
Yeah, I'm done talking to you people.
Fair enough.
Yeah.
Well, I'm Kramer.
I'm Juan.
I'm Tom, sometimes.
And we'll talk to you guys later.
Wait, what... Before we sign off, people should go to audibletrial.com/shootingblanks.
One. And we took a break. The commercial's going in the break.
We should do it now.
Commercial so that I could go pee.
Oh, we didn't say that. Yeah, I don't forget all that.
We did talk about this.
There was an entire segment devoted to that very thing.
If you took a piss while Tom was taking a piss and you missed out on our commercial.
I don't think that's how commercials work on podcasts. You can go to
audibletrial.com /shootingblanks and get a free audiobook.
Okay,
and
just put this in front of the commercial.
Goodbye, everyone.
No editing was harmed in the creation of this segment.
No hedgehogs?
Editing.
Oh.
No editing.
I don't know where I heard hedgehogs.
No hedgehogs to create.
No hedgehogs were harmed in the creation of this segment.
Except Sonic.
Except Sonic's character.
No, his children.
And his children. And we apparently created a story murdering his kids.
Yeah.
Okay. We created only to destroy.
Okay, bye.
Bye.